kind of have to read. At my age, I can't remember much anymore. So I prepared some information. I can't beat what was just supplied to you, but I maybe can fill in a few things. I lived here in Cleveland when I was young. My parents moved here in 1945. And so we lived on East 128th Street off of Miles Avenue on the east side. And so it's really nice to be back in Cleveland again. It's been a long time. My family left Cleveland in 1958. And I've been back here several times, which I'll talk about in a minute, but it's always nice to be back here. As I've told a few, Frank Jirouch was my grandfather's brother and my great uncle. And through the years, we just always referred to him as Uncle Frank. So just about all of the relatives use that terminology. And we're really here today because of my youngest son, Eric, who he's been very interested in the family history, and in particular, he's done some work on the internet checking on Uncle Frank's work. And so, somehow or another, Lucia Lippitt, is that the proper pronunciation, got in touch with Eric through the internet, through Facebook or something, and he contacted me, and between us, he supplied her with some information for a write-up that she did on Uncle Frank back a year or so ago. I can't remember how long ago. So, I want to thank Mr. Gert and Ms. Lippitt for having us here today, and what they've done to help us meet here today. I also mentioned to my son Eric, I said after he got done talking with Ms. Lippitt, I said, well, I would like to go back to Cleveland sometime before I get too old to travel. And I think the Federation contacted with him through Lucia, and one thing led to another, and that's why we're here today. Now, I was asked to try and supply some personal information for my great uncle. And so I can't really supply a whole lot on his personal life. That's one of the reasons we're here too, because we're trying to learn about who he was. We didn't have much interface with him during the 50s when I was here. So we're glad for the opportunity to be here to find out what we can too. Now, when I was in Cleveland in the 50s, I was a teenager and I didn't have a lot of interest in the arts. So now, much later, I wish I had, and I wish I'd had more interface with my great uncle, but that didn't happen. As you've already heard, Uncle Frank and Aunt May did not have any children. They weren't able to have any. And they lived on the west side of Cleveland, whereas we lived on the east side. So there was very little interface between the two parts of the family, except at Christmas get-togethers. And my cousin Gail said that at the get-togethers, and I had forgotten this, my old age has taken my memory away from me, that he always brought a piece of his work. And they would all get reach in a hat, you know, and get out a number or whatever they did.
And drawing.
Draw for it, and somebody, whoever the winner was, got that piece of art that year. So.
Well, there's a lot of stuff out there that nobody knows is out there.
So I know everybody knows that he was a sculptor in Cleveland, and he was very involved in his work and associates, both business and professional, and rightly so, because he was a very talented man. But because of that, most of what my family knows about Uncle Frank is in the form of newspaper articles and photographs and of his sculptures. For instance, we talked about Mark Twain, I don't know if you've ever seen that one.
No, I haven't seen that one.
You can have it.
That would be great. We'll pass it around. I'd like to get it back.
So I brought that, a few photographs to share with you. One of them was a personal painting of him that was done by an associate in 1917. And this painting is on oil, on canvas, and it's 36 high by 27 wide. And it was in his personal collection. And when he died, it was passed on through the direct descendants of the Jirouch family. And currently, that's in my possession. So I took that picture, and you can have that too.
Great. We'll put that in our.
In 1967, my wife Elaine and my oldest son Eddie, who was a little under 1 year old at the time, came to Cleveland, and we visited with Uncle Frank and Aunt May. And here's some pictures of when we were here. And they were at his house, and they had a flower garden in their back with an archway and everything.
Do you know where he lived in, on the west side?
Yeah, on Essex Road.
Essex
off the
Road.
Essex Road.
Don't
know it, huh?
I heard the name, I can't place it.
You know where Lee Road is?
Okay.
Yeah, it's in Cleveland. You go out all the way Lee Road to Cleveland Heights.
Well, that's the west, that's the east side.
But that's east side.
Yeah,
wow.
It really
is.
Cleveland Heights, yeah.
So that's the only photographic memory I have of our visit back then with him. And one of the things I asked him when we talked with him was about, I said, Uncle Frank, how come you pronounce your name Jirouch? And he said, well, that's a French name. So if you ever speak about Uncle Frank and you want to use his name Jirouch, I'm sure he'd be happy to hear that. That's the way he pronounced it, Jirouch. Now, when my parents passed away in 2006, I was in charge of cleaning out his workshop, my father's workshop, which was a horrendous mess. It was packed from one end of the other. And in there I found an old cardboard box, and it was full of old scrapbooks of Uncle Frank's. And it was a terrible mess. It was moldy and dirty and all that, and I wanted to throw it all out. Thanks to my wife, we saved it, took it home, and she convinced me, through much distress on herself, to peel all those pictures off of that old musty paper and keep them. And a lot of newspaper articles, the Plain Dealer, that kind of thing. So we have all that at home, and I'm hoping to copy all that into the computer and make a DVD. When that happens,
we'd love to have it. Maybe we have a place for it. I'll mention
that. It's got pictures of a lot of his sculpt, you know, the bust that he did and that kind of thing.